Now that most of us have had our lives come to a standstill due to the coronavirus pandemic, going into self-isolation at home and having a lot of free time on our hands, isn't it time to sit down and ask ourselves about the big questions in life? Especially at a time of uncertainty when so many people around us are dying, and who knows, you could be next. And so, what is the purpose of life? Why am I here? Where am I going? These are deep questions that require a lot of contemplation. And so think about it. Is our purpose in this world simply to eat, sleep, work, acquire some material things, and enjoy ourselves? If that was the case, then how are we different than animals? We human beings are special and different from all other species. With our consciousness, our intellect, our feelings, it's illogical to believe that we came about in this world by mere chance, without an intelligent, all-powerful creator who created us and created us for a wise purpose. Some people like to argue that there is no proof that God exists. There is no proof that we human beings were created by God for a divine purpose. Well, when you see the design of this universe, as well as life on Earth, you see a very accurate and precise design in front of you, and something this accurate and precise could not have been just thrown together. Do all of these things in our universe and here on Earth function perpetually and perfectly by chance? And do they keep on reproducing themselves and maintaining themselves also by chance? No, of course not. That would be totally illogical to believe. And so the design, the order, the complexity of the universe, as well as the world around us, is all evidence of the existence of a supreme intelligent being, a perfect designer. All the celestial bodies are controlled by precise laws of physics. Can there be laws without a lawmaker? And so the universe, the earth, and living things on earth all give silent testimony to an intelligent, powerful creator. Well, such is God, who created this universe and all that is in it, a superior divine being who brought all of this together and created it in total perfection. He is the Almighty God, the Creator, Allah, who has knowledge to design and has created this entire universe. He is the only one deserving of our praise, our gratitude, and our worship. If we agree that we were made by a Creator, then surely that Creator must have informed us about who He is and what He expects from us. It's not logically acceptable that God would leave us in this world to wander in confusion about who God is and what God wants from us. When you read a book, you accept that an author exists. When you see a house, you accept that a builder exists. Both of these things were made with a purpose by those who made them. Once we understand this, we understand that God has indeed communicated with us and told us about Himself and the purpose behind creating us. God sent many prophets and messengers throughout history for the sole purpose of guiding us humans to understand who God is and what God wants from us. But God's final message to us human beings was revealed to one man, and that was Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, through the angel Gabriel. God said in His final revelation to mankind, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِن قَبْلِكَ مِن رَّسُولٍ إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَاعْبُدُونِ. And we did not send any messenger before you, but we inspired him, saying, there is no true God but I, so worship me. Now coming back to our original question, what is the purpose of life? The answer? The purpose of life for all men and women for all times has been one and the same. To know God and live our lives the way God has dictated. God said in the Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have not created the spirits nor the human beings for any other purpose except to worship me. And so that, in a nutshell, is the purpose of your life. The purpose behind why you were created was so that you could recognize the Creator and worship Him. So that you surrender yourself to what He has commanded and to obey his laws that he has determined for you. This is your purpose in this life. If I was to give you $100 for no other reason than just to listen to me today, you would at least say thank you. Now what about your eyes, your brain, your heart, your breath? What about all of that? Who gave you all of that? Is he who gave you all of that not worthy of praise and thanks? My sincere recommendation to you is to take a translation of the Quran and read it for yourself. But before that, find a secluded place in your home and ask the Creator of the heavens and the earth for guidance, and be sincere and persistent in your prayer. And trust me, as long as you're sincerely looking to find the truth, then the All-Merciful, the All-Loving, Almighty God, Allah, He will hear you and He will respond to your prayer.